Hello guys, welcome to Life Probe, where we inspire one life at a time. I'm your host, Knowledge, and welcome to another episode of Mancot, where we empower the next generation of men. And so guys, the topic of today, we're talking about friendship. And I'm not alone. Today, as you can see, I have a guest. He's called Byron. Byron is a lawyer by profession. And so welcome, Sana. Welcome, Byron.
Thanks. To our set. Thank you very much for having me.
So welcome, Byron, to our set. It's an honor to have you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, we call you our learned friends. Yeah. It's interesting that today we're talking about friendship, and you being a lawyer, there's this kind of mentality that there's a group. Lawyers have their own cocoon of friends.
Well, let me just say, it's maybe that tag of learned friends.
Mm-hmm.
Let me just say, the bond that is created when we are together through the 4 years in campus and the 1.5 years in School of Law,
mm-hmm.
It kind of gels us together. Plus, this is a noble profession we inherited from the Wazungus, so to inherit kutoka kwao.
Yeah.
But we also take pride in it because we've earned it anyway. So.
Yeah, true.
Yeah.
True.
Yeah.
And you from that kind of bond from campus to law school, do you also have other kind of friends who are not in the same profession?
Yes. In fact, I normally encourage myself. It's funny you should ask that question. You know, one senior friend of mine always thought I would marry a lawyer.
Wow.
And I have never been rigid in terms of friends or even potential partners, because currently I'm single. I'm single, but yes, single, but searching.
Underline and share to gallop.
Yes.
Yeah.
So yes, I've discovered in my very short span in this earth that the world is a very big place. It's a huge place. If you get opportunities to meet people and to know more cultures, the better for you.
Yeah.
I've been privileged to even travel outside the country. I've met people from different. I've come to appreciate people have different cultures and different values. So it's actually an added advantage for one to get friends from all sectors of life, so long as they impact you positively.
Mm-hmm.
They don't impact you negatively. You know, there are some who come to deduct the value from you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I would say, yes, I've never constrained myself to my profession.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And coming back to a bit of campus, law is a very serious and delicate kind of study compared to other courses.
Yeah.
And it requires a lot of time, you know, a lot of commitments. And now in going back into campus, you know, there's this kind of friends you meet straight out of high school, and guys are hyped about life.
Mm.
You know, they are doing courses which are not, they don't require as much
time.
Yeah, yeah. As you. How did you go about that?
Well, you know, wanasemanga, birds of a feather flock together.
Yeah.
It's a coincidence that almost all law schools in Kenya, mm-hmm. name any, they are outside main campus. Egerton is in town. Main campus is in Joro. The law school is in town here. For JQuat, the law campus is in Parklands. The main campus is in Juja.
Mm-hmm.
As we were in Parklands, I was in University of Nairobi. The main campus was in CBD town. So that kind of also, how can I say, it encouraged guys to psych each other in terms of reading.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't want to belittle what Walifanya BA, but you see them, they had more time than us. Even I remember when we could go for sports days, what BA had all the time. CC, in fact, let me say, if there's a profession I respect very much, ni doctors, actuarial, medicine, guys who did medicine and actuarial science.
Mm-hmm.
I remember in first year, I had very many friends who we were in high school together, and they went to do those courses. And I can tell you, I used to see them with lab coats. Every week, lab coats, they are going for practicals. They have practicals every week. So theirs is a bit more technical than ours.
Yeah.
So you see now, because they were in their own campus, they would, in a way, they were clustered together.
Mm-hmm.
So they would, Sisemiati, they were separated from these others because these others didn't have anything better to do.
Yeah.
But the coincidental situation that you find yourself, Sakama Sisi, were only in Parklands together. You know, you even see your friends going to the library in the morning, yeah. Some of them transnighting. It gives you, it in a kuamsha, you are like, hey, okay, kumbe people are reading.
Yeah.
I also have to. And also, it's about also self-conviction. No, at the end of the day, it is about you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, many people don't realize the way you leave high school alone. You know, when you leave high school, you are alone.
Yeah.
When you are in there, when you are in that rende, you know, you kuna yo rende mentality, yeah. Yes, we are the cool group in the school, no problem. When you finish form 4, you are alone.
Split.
When you leave that gate,
yeah.
It's the same thing with campus. So anyone focused, the first day akiingia, unajuliza, what am I going there to do? What, mm-hmm. after those 4 years or 5 or 6, or some go for 6 years,
mm-hmm.
what would I have achieved there? So it is you to measure yourself. Yeah, it's good to have friends there, but they are from BA, from this other maybe perceived simpler causes. But it is you to have that conviction. You're like, okay, me as Byron, I went to law school. Now I would sit myself down and ask myself, okay, guys, what BA have more time for sports than me.
Mm-hmm.
So how do I jipanga myself in such a way that my academics is not punctured and I still have a friendship with them? And I'm telling you that conviction, you must have it all the way through your life. I've even seen it in my after campus, even in my working life. You have to, sometimes you want to hang out with friends, but you have something pending to do them, they don't.
Yeah.
Will you stick in that hotel drinking tea with them?
Mm-hmm.
No. You will tell them, hey guys, I have something quick, very urgent to do. Mm-hmm. Nipatie nafasi kidogo. And yeah, so I would probably say it's self-discipline. That you have to be self-disciplined and say, and know what you want and know your goals.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And mostly you find when you are in campus, there are people who you went into campus which you are peers, you know, you're the same level age, and so they expect you're expected to click direct to them, so the things that they do it naturally spreads in you. But now looking like you, you're doing law and other guys are doing other courses, so the time you have with them is very limited. But there's that kind of pressure that, hey, it's a weekend, you know, 20 out. You know,
yeah,
it's,
I understand.
So how do you try to navigate through that kind of career influence?
It's funny you should say that. You know, I came to learn a very funny way. When I was in first year, the clique I had, Tulukoma boys, who were like 4 or 5 of us, I think. It's only, amongst the 5, 6 of us, it's only one person atuko high school na all the rest of us were in the same
high school. High school,
yeah. We found ourselves in law school patena pamoja.
Wow.
So by some funny chance, after second year I found myself having another clique altogether, because you see now, for the I changed classes, I went to the evening class,
mm-hmm.
then they remained in the day class, and the evening class has more mature guys. These are guys who are working, yeah, and working whatnot, so that's the time they are dating. So that's the time they have to read. But in a way, it kind of gave me an advantage in that by mingling with those mature people, it made me look at life in a very different perspective. To be honest, you know, your day class ni watu wenye, they are there, they are not working, they are just there to read. So you see them, they are yo sasa ndio yo click, yeah, to end out wapi na nini na nini, yeah. You see. Then they have all the spare time. Mm-hmm. But when you actually, who you hang around with influences you a lot. Because I used to hang around with those guys and they would be like, ah, okay. Like one encouraged me to get a part-time job when I was almost finishing campus. So it kind of also opened my horizons to how working life is and all that.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I can say also about peer influence. Okay. My friends, that time, you know, I was a bit, I was younger. Let me just be very frank with you.
Mm-hmm.
I was very young, you know. excitement ya maisha iko hapo.
Yeah.
I've just from high school, you know, especially sisi wenye tulienda boarding schools, once you leave home for you feel like
the freedom is
yes, right. Freedom imerudi. You are like ulikuwa umefungwa for 4 years
yeah.
And now you are free. And then me I went to a boys school. We never used to see chicks around. Mademo akikuja funky hiyo shule ina cheese. Then you finish form 4. Now you have the chicks are there.
Yeah.
Hey, wako. And then campus is very dangerous. Hamchungui vile mko mnachungua
high school.
You go to class if you want to,
mm-hmm.
but there are consequences if you don't.
If you don't.
You can do any you can. Ay bana, there are some guys even used to 10 a.m. asubuhi na wako kwa pub ya shule bana. In the morning. So, it's about having your own discipline. You know, it's very funny. Like I remember one person used to challenge me. I'll go and be, I was in fourth year, his first year. He used to tell me, nini mnaenda kukatiana katiana na madimu. Lakini usiku nini msazile mmelala na macheza mapiesu kwa rumzenyu. Awa kwa library wanasoma. And it is so true. One day I was very curious and I went to that library. My friend there, alikuwa amejazana hivi.
Studying.
Yes. So you see now, wewe ukijifanya hapo, wewe ndo Mr. Perfect.
Yeah.
Ati, sewa, watakupenda tu. Lakini, wacha siku ya kiyama ya exam ifike. And the results come out, I'm telling you, they don't even remember who you are. So it's about you self-drive, knowing your purpose there. What did you ulienda kwa kufanya nini? Friends can influence you in a positive and a negative way at the same time. And I've come to also learn, that pressure doesn't stop ukiwa campus. Inaendelea hata, I've even seen guys who are maybe my parents' age, and they're really influenced by their friends on what they do. Like, how can I say it? I'll just say rika yangu, so I want to put it in a very respectful way. This one time we went to a party somewhere in our friend's place, and you could see the hosts, they were really, they wanted everything to be perfect. They really wanted to impress their guests.
Mm-hmm.
So your pressure, like, you know, my friends are not just what we've, so I want to have someone, I want to make to create a good picture.
Impression.
Yeah, a good impression. So they influence you even way, friends influence you way beyond, even in your sunset years.
Mm.
Yeah. Some friends, you know, some friends influence you to do, good friends will influence you to do good things.
Mm-hmm.
I have friends who are at my age who are married. So when we meet after work for tea, so maybe if it's busy, say, kuna curfew. Those days, okay, sorry, curfew, say. Those days when there were no curfews, we would meet for tea, maybe to take up at assembly. Those of us who are single, we don't have children, and, yeah. But those of us who have wives and we got no akumbushanga kwa zikifika 7, we would tell them life.
Mm.
Like, we would personally tell them, jobs, you simam, you nini bana, masani. Because also, you see also, by you being a good friend like that, even their wives come to like you.
Mm.
They don't even feel insecure when they hear their husbands are with you.
Mm-hmm.
That's, we're gonna buy Byron, sawa. But trust me, if you are not someone who, you know, there are those who are like, they give you very bad advice.
Yeah.
Ati, wewe ndo dume ya nyumba, fanya tafanya nini.
Wewe unagurumi.
Yeah, and when you go back there, you unachomeka wewe peke yako. Your friends are not there to take the heat from your wife with you. But it's also about responsibility. So, it would be very unfair to us. Even if we go to forums where singles are many, would be very conscious of the things we're exposing our married friends to.
Mm.
So they don't get tempted to sabotage their marriages, you know.
Mm.
If I knew I was going to a place where any forum ya singles, kabisa na nona, maybe if the topic that was discussed there will prejudice my married friends, I wouldn't tell them to go.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's the same thing. Even with girls, you know, between you and me, sometimes if I want to gauge how mature girl is, I will also look at her friends.
Yeah.
There are those friends who will tell her, oh boy, I'm a ziako na dos. You want me to buy a lunch na nini na nini. My friend ran from those. So, friends can influence you negatively and positively at the same time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And going to that influence, does it bring the matter of now character? You know, you being, you, let's say you coming from another different place like Nakuru, you're from Nax, and now going to Nairobi, find the cool kids, you know.
Yeah.
They have the life, you know.
It's funny you should say that. You know, us were in Parklands, eh? And some guys I went to school with, they came from very humble backgrounds. But the way they used to live and portray themselves.
Very different.
Yeah, very different. Very different. And you see, just be yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Because you cannot hide who you are. Because especially tukimaliza shule, itatoka tu vizuri, tutajua kwenye ni wote. So, because the chicks, hey, they used to be like, ah, this guy is not taking me out for pizza. And sijui, haizi nichukua na kabia, sijui, 2000. Na siyo si tukwa campus, hata 500 ni lunch ya wiki mbili.
Mess.
Yeah, kwa mess. So, it is very funny that they used to feel like, oh, tumepanda bain, and and you are only there for 4 years to read, to better your life so that you can reach that level you want, you see. And that is why even most of the friends I maintained from there, you know, I was never afraid to be myself. You know, sometimes also, unfortunately, people want to know where you are or what you do so that they know how much respect to give you.
Yeah.
Or how much. I never, like for me, my... when I was in first year, second year, my dad used to work abroad that time. So one day he came, seriously needed a laptop to do my research works. So he was passing by the school, going to the airport. Now, one thing I like with my dad, he has very, anakuwa na sixth sense. Anajua sanctuary ya mwanaume zima linaingia ingia tu.
Yeah.
So the place where I used to stay, he only came siku ya kureport peke. Ile tu kujua, my son stays here.
Yeah.
So that in case if anything happens, I know where to find him. But all the time we wanted to meet, we would meet for tea maybe in Westlands, somewhere near the mall, huko, or just outside. So that day, hakuwa amenishtua. Anambia, I'm coming to bring you that laptop. So if he did a mistake, I always told him never to park near the parking, apo near the school there, Andani. So unfortunately, he comes when we are just finishing class. Then all, yes, tunatoka all with all of my buddies. I don't want to say what he was driving. Tumetoka na all of my buddies. Okay. With all of my buddies. So after that, I'm telling you some, especially, unfortunately, especially the ladies, they used to treat me very differently. They were like,
from that incident.
Yes, from that day. They're like, even one time some of them, we bumped into them. Were Mimi, my dad, and my bro, who were meeting for lunch for pizza at a joint somewhere. And we bumped. So after that, they were like, Kumbe, you guys, you come to places like this and you are so quiet. I was like, okay, Aki, to be very respectful, how plastic can you get? Just because to enda vibanda kunywa lunch does not mean I have the value to date you. Unaona? That's unfortunately how sasa tulikuwa tunaangaliwa. So just let me say this, appreciate, be content with where you are as you pray and you hope for God to exalt you to the next level. Contentment is a virtue. I can tell you majority of Kenyans really lack. You already, for example, right now at least the corona has exposed one thing. If you have clothes on your back, if you're eating and you have a roof over your head, you're fine. Even if you're not going to that mall, you're not going to buy those things, those luxury things, it's only extra. People at least have come to see that.
Yeah.
This. So be content. If you have, enye Mungu amekubariki nayo, thank God for that while you hope for. So you see that time people are, oh, sasa tuko Parklands. And I'm telling you, it was crazy. Sometimes I was a victim. You feel, for me, I think it was a bit easier for me because I'm fortunate to come from a family that's well off. But I would see some of my buddies when, sazimini hata walikuwa wanangoanga and would really jishikilia to si cheke. And you see, I liked those who were just themselves. Yeah. Because there was one guy from Meru I really liked. He used to even have a very deep Meru accent. Always proud of. He reminds me of James Mwangi. I like, he's very atashrab danini, but yeah, look, he's successful.
True. Yeah.
He's not ashamed of who he is. Yeah. If you are confident in yourself, if you're confident in yourself, people will never hurt a kubeba if you hurt on a wound. Always have confidence in yourself.
Yeah. Mm. And people try to look for value in from other things, especially materialistic things, you know. Yeah. Someone wants to impress, you know, girls, especially when you have this clique of friends, which, you know, they are like, hey, we are Subaru boys, you know. So you must get like a car, you know.
You know, it's funny. Mm. As Madimwa Parklands, they used to be very different from Madimwa main campus. Chicks in main campus, I can say they were a bit, okay, I don't know how it is now, but that was a bit, I graduated in 2015.
Mm.
That I, from my own observation as me, Madimwa Parklands, maybe because of where we were, or I don't know. And also, Pia, some of them were from very well-off families, yes. They were, and then also, Ujo Pia parking lot imejama parado na manene, so they would be like, ay, mbona niende Byron pale, amekuja tu na jeans na sandals, ametoka kwa hostel. Na kuseo kuna ninja ana drive hapa, and that's how things were. Those, not all of them were like that, by the way. Because I even have friends who are dating from campus and wamewana. But those situations are there.
Mm-hmm.
So, it just comes back to what I said earlier. Be yourself. I'll be very frank with you. Sometimes that pressure has got to me, you know.
Mm.
You find yourself even spending money you didn't have because you want to impress a certain. I'm not saying today I will not put my best foot forward, but there are levels I will not go to impress a chick. Let me not lie to you. I will put my best foot forward. I will, and then also, you know, I'll that time, you know, campus. I don't know if it's generational. But I always wished to leave campus with a wife material to me. My parents met in campus. You know, testimony yangu imetoka kwa nyumba.
Yeah.
So I always thought I would have a, I always dreamed to have a story like theirs.
Mm.
But God revealed to me watu wanakuanga na stories zao later on. So I always thought I would leave, you know. But katikati, I came to see that in our generation, I don't know, people in campus, people still want to have that fun like high school. Our jam comma. Wazazi wetu like a chick by 23 already was married with children. Today chicks who are 23 are busy in seps.
Slaying.
Yes. So our walikuwa wamejipanga mapema. Yeah, that's what you see for them. In a way, their blueprint for their marriage life and nini was kind of a certainty. See kama sisi, you know. This is something that can happen to anyone, by the way. Some people think they're immune at yes. So long as you are a human being, you are not immune to such things. So anyway, what I would say, just be yourself. The reason why I said I always thought I would leave campus with a chick. My wife might dim as a woman to attack my wife. I always prayed for that. But Mungu ana mpango zingine. But you see, I came to discover that time, by the way, the Madim Tulena now campus, most of them, they are very different. Now, majority are married with kids. The way they used to behave then, sikasa. In fact, sometimes I don't recognize them.
Very different.
Yes, very different. It's like they have matured. Mm-hmm. So it's like now their agenda in campus was have the fun, then after campus, get serious.
Yeah.
But what I saw with our generation, Zama Mazetu, they were serious from the get-go, and especially because of the other time they had O-level and A-levels content, they have nothing.
Yeah.
This other side, they have everything, but the environment there is not. So it is... Let's not exalt things that are vanity when we are marketing ourselves, or when we are looking also for... Even for even when it comes to friends, when it comes to the relationships, genuineness is a very important thing.
And going just a little bit about now the social aspect right now, especially in our generation, you know, what is happening right now is we have clique of friends who are, you know, they are saying, no, they are like the kings of social media, you know, every chick knows this guy, you know, and so you want to be associated with them. But also because of your image, you want to protect yourself, but still have the clique of friends who are trying to church, you know, Sunday they're in church. Yeah. Can you balance, or do you have to make a decision, or how will it affect you?
Well, okay. I don't want to get very personal answering that question, because personally, I'm not saying I'm not a fan of social media, but I've never been a fan of advertising your life on social media. By the way, social media, when it started, it was about guys getting to know each other, but also getting to reunite with old friends. I joined FB way back in high school, Nikimaliza. A friend of mine helped to open an account for me.
So it was a big deal by then.
Yeah, that time it was actually being in Facebook at your Facebook account, but ukombele. Because say people even have five.
Yeah.
So now, if I was to be very real with you, I wouldn't go, hata nikuwe dema machali, I wouldn't go for someone who is so much of a celeb on social media. I'm not saying you cannot find someone who is good, who is a celeb, who is a social media guru. But most social media personalities tend to be too controversial, you know. Now, I would say this, what would be the use of having 3,000 friends on Facebook? But the day you are in need, only five appear. You see?
Yeah.
Now, you can also, by the way, you can maintain a life, a holy life in church, and you can still have that social media presence. I've seen it, even with peers way older than me, my parents, Rika. But you have to be very careful about the things you do there, about the things you post there, about the things you follow also. Because it really impacts a lot on your life and your mentality. I never thought until ningia teenagehood and maybe high school how some celebrities can really impact the way you think.
Yeah.
So if you follow, if you have a funny role model, you tanza to kama yeah. So I would say, now sorry to say this, okay, they have social media personalities who they at a vile wanajipeba, they respect themselves. Can mention some of them. I respect Kambua, I respect Evelyn Wanjiru, and what's the common thing about those names I've mentioned, they are Christians.
Yeah.
But I would really want you to go to Pejia, and I have nothing against her, but endo wangale Pejia, Nadia Mugami, one of it was supposed to happen. Would you watch that with your parents?
No.
Exactly. So you see, and also now let me also tell you, sometimes some circumstances can make you, some circumstances will force you to mingle with them. For example, work. Now, that is why you also have to be very smart on how you navigate. For work, you see, like for me, I cannot dictate how my workmates will live. But I have to work with them.
Yeah.
But I have to be careful that their lifestyle does not brush on mine.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I would say you can have that. Social media just needs discipline. You can have that. You can have those friendships. You can have as many friends as you want, but also, as I said, also, what is the need of having 5,000 friends? You know, some there's no one to me post kitu, I'm a pata like smiana na fila pana, you age a fee,
but
yeah. So, personally, I've never been so near about likes, like, oh, this one got 500 likes, it is fine. But what is the main agenda? What is the okay? Does this social media erode your character or inakujenga? The people who you mingle with there, what you post, who you follow, who you look up to there, do they erode your thinking? I used to see bana kama sisi, I'm very frank with you, unajua tukiwa teenagers kazi ilikuwa tu mademi. Sasa hivi you grow up, you unakoma, you meet God along the way, your thinking becomes totally different. So it's just social media is just a place you have to be very careful.
Yeah.
You know, how you navigate it, as people normally blunder, especially with what they post. Let me tell you, the camera never forgets. Yeah. And I remember one time Nani saying that she was being interviewed. Although she wasn't regretting, this lady alikuwa na imba secular kitambo, she's in Valley Road now. Amina.
Yeah.
Simajua Amina.
Yeah,
Amina. I mean, it's Yalkoa, but she, I can't say she was as controversial as Akina size 8 during that time.
Mm.
But you see, now, for example, now, I've seen, I've seen a video, it is still there on YouTube. There was a concert somewhere where size 8 was performing, and the dances that were going on there were a bit funny.
Mm.
But you see, now, ameokoka.
Yeah.
But you see, that Nini is still there.
It's still there.
I'm not saying, you see, unfortunately, human minds are not like God's mind. Go mungu kile mungu na wanga na iresa.
Mm.
Akikusamehea amekusamehea. Lakini ya binadamu.
Mm.
If to like unfortunately, yeah, like unfortunately if today Vera got saved. You see the camera still there. Yeah. So I'm not saying that we should live with regret or not. When you're when God finds you are a new being, that is fine.
Mm.
But it is unfortunately the reality of life that social media impacts you kwenda mbele. Even, sorry to say, even sometimes when you've passed on, some things used to post there, watu watakuwa like, ay bana, hii ilikuwa.
Surely.
But there's someone who got, a lady who lost a government job. She was seconded by a prominent politician.
Mm.
She lost that job because of a post. She had put almost 3 years before, castigating the very group she was to get a job there.
Wow.
You see how social media can destroy you.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it can be a good thing and it can be a bad thing at the same time. Yeah.
Wow. Mm. I see time is not on our side, but at the last question, because I don't want to go to about relationships, because friends really dictate a lot in relationships, but that's a topic for another day. I want to wind up on about finances, because we are seeing guys who are around 40 years, you know, but they don't have families. These are guys who still go to clubs, they still have the same friends, and their friends now dictate their finances, you know. Someone is aging up and still doesn't have land, you know. The money he gets is just, you know, throwing out to clubs, friends.
Now, finances, friends and finances, I'll say this. You know, when you fly with eagles, you'll think like an eagle.
Yeah.
And when you fly with chickens, you'll think like a chicken.
Mm.
I'd first say, surround yourself with the people who are where you want to be. That's the first thing I would say. I normally surround myself with friends or seniors in my profession when you are a make. So I get to know what do they do, how did they get there.
Yeah.
What are the challenges along the way? Now, I'll tell you one thing. Okay, yeah, friends can also influence your finances, because also the type of friends you keep. There are some who will encourage you to invest. Some are just to save. Yeah. Unaona hii period ya corona, it has really taught people the value of saving.
Yeah.
A lot. Now, with finances, let me say, each stage of life has its own needs and its own wants and its own, you have your own goals. When you were in high school, your goals are not there like the ones you have in campus.
Mm-hmm.
And I can guarantee you the goals you have in campus are not the ones you have in Uvukishamaliza when you start working life.
Yeah.
In my short working life, like in campus that time, my preoccupation was, because me, I wanted to have a jump start on my life after 4 years. You go and tackle it, it's a period I don't know, I'm just there. So I used to be like, every penny I save, I buy something for my potential place where I will stay, my house. Now, after finishing campus, your avenues for finances expand. So by the way, the more the finances, the more responsibility you're supposed to have. Trust me. The more money, that's what I say. If I can't trust you the 100, how can I trust you the 100 million? So you have to be very disciplined how you use your money. Get friends who helped you invest. Juzi in church we had a speaker who was teaching guys about investing and in it. He talked about the stages of some stages of life in terms of investing and also thinking capacity. In your 20s, that is the time to make the mistakes. That's the time you make mistakes, you learn from them. You get into a bad deal, or you maybe get into a bad clique where who poteza you to use money is you happy. So, but the funny enough, by some miracle, by the time you hit 30, unajiuliza, ay, manye, by the money I used in that 1 year pekee ningekuwa na save, I would have done something with it. Fine. You now the 30s, the ones I got was 20s, 30s, 40s. In your 30s now, that is where you implement. In 20s is where you have the dream and where you also make the mistakes. In your 30s is where you implement the dream now. You start implementing the dream, actualizing it. You actualize that house you want, you actualize that business you want, that family you want also. Some actualize it at 20, fine. Some do it at 30. In 40 now, at 40 is when this is now when these things you were investing in are supposed to be kind of blooming now. Upon the returns of these investments, you see. If you're starting, okay, some people have started investing at 40 and have succeeded, fine. But the speaker was encouraging us to start as early even as our 20s. Even that 100 bob you have, save it. It goes a long way. So, you see now, also one factor you have to look at is the stage of life you are in also. Because also the stage, the friends I had maybe in campus, some of them I... what the end, I mean, are not the friends I have now. The mentality I had then was not the mentality I have now. So just surround yourself with friends who I would really encourage who have gone ahead of you, who are there, who are where you want to be. Have friends who, and even if you have friends whom level moja bado, friends who are thinking maendeleo, friends who are telling you knowledge, I have some 500 G somewhere. Situshikani hivi tufungwe kabizi ama tu see, si mwenye ati yoye manzi kuna mayang flani niliona pale hivyo na you know
Jessica.
And let me even shock you. See, okay, don't even yesterday I was telling someone, you know, so even these people you see going to you up in up in up in, some of them are not foolish. You know, it's funny, some of they are not saved but they are not foolish. I don't understand. This person will go to Sebs and drink, but ile pesa I invest is 90% yenye anakunywa ni
10%.
So I asked myself, ai bana, mimi mwenye najua Mungu naweza tolewa rangi na mtu kama huyo. Yeah, so it's just about having sound friends, having friends who are wanaangalia mbele, and also having the right mentors to guide you to that financial goal that you want to go to. Yeah.
Wow, my goodness, what a serious sit down. Thank you, Byron, for it's a pleasure having you.
Thank you very
this
much.
Is a conversation that we need to get back to, especially about going into relationships. It's something that really affects especially us guys, you know, and it's a conversation that we should keep on trending, you know. So thank you for watching. This is Life Probe Man Court edition. Don't forget to subscribe. Life Probe. You see, we have new t-shirts, by the way. My director, zenda pesa ngapi?
650
shillings. Only. Do you have giveaways? Tutajua. But thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Let's continue on sharing. Follow us on all our social media platforms at Life Probe. We leave a number below in case you need a t-shirt. We have the yellow one and the maroon one. So thank you very much. Thank you, Byron.
Thank you very much.
See you on the next episode of Man Court. Ciao.